I'm very excited about this one, the new ASUS ROG Republic of Gamers Phone 2. It just came out 2 months ago in September, and I have one in my possession right here. My 2-year cell phone commitment ended about 10 days ago. I took the time to review all the new phones and the ones coming out first quarter of next year. That's a bunch of exciting new phones. I chose this phone over all the others because of its specs, looks, and price. Indeed, it's a great time for a new phone. If you watch this unboxing and disagree with me, you can't go wrong with some of the other new phones. As a matter of fact, my wife is also getting a new phone. She's excited about her choice, the iPhone 11 Pro Max. I have a link in the description for that unboxing. So let's get started with the specs. We've got a 6.59-inch full high-def AMOLED display, 2340 by 1080 with 10-bit HDR. It does not have Dolby Vision. That's not the best, but when you add its buttery smooth 120Hz display, that makes it stand out. Next, it has the industry-leading Snapdragon 855 Plus Octa-Core 2.96 GHz processor. What's the Plus all about? It's slightly overclocked, the CPU at 4% and the GPU at 15%. It has 12 gigabytes of RAM. This model has 512 gigabytes of storage. That's huge for a phone. I will never run out of space on this phone. And that's good because it does not have a removable storage tray. Next, it has a 6,000 milliamp battery, one of the largest ever put on a phone. For some people, this will be a deal breaker because the phone will just be too big and too heavy. When I open the box, you can see how it fits in my hand. I'm 5'9" with not very large hands. It has 25-watt fast charging with a 30-watt charger included in the box. This phone has high-quality dual front-facing speakers. Next, it has dual cameras on the back, 48-megapixel plus 13-megapixel wide-angle. It has a 24-megapixel selfie camera on the front. Other reviews are saying that they are very good, but not the best. If you want the absolute best camera on a phone, you may want to select a different new phone, like my wife's selection, the iPhone 11 Pro Max. This phone also has Corning Gorilla Glass 6, like most of the new high-end phones, excluding foldable phones. I think this is a very attractive phone. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, so you may see it differently once I open the box. Next, price. I paid $899 plus tax from Amazon. That's quite inexpensive for one of the fastest phones ever made. Right now, this phone is hard to get. It's out of stock almost everywhere, including the ASUS store. This is before Black Friday, not after. I had to check Amazon 4 to 6 times a day until they got a new batch. I ordered it as soon as they did. Now, this one I have is an LTE unlocked dual SIM phone, US version. It's not compatible with CDMA networks, Verizon, Sprint, and US Cellular. Let me repeat, it is not compatible with CDMA networks, Verizon, Sprint, and US Cellular. I don't know if this phone is available for those carriers. I called my carrier, Consumer Cellular, prior to purchase after my questions to them I was good to go. Next, it has screen fingerprint unlock, face ID unlock, touchpad unlock, but there's not a heart rate sensor. It looks like the industry is removing that from almost all new phones this year. If that's a deal breaker for you, you can find the heart rate sensor on the Samsung Galaxy S10 and S10 Plus, but not on the S10 Lite. Or you can get a watch with that feature. And there's one other big aspect about this phone, gaming. I didn't buy it for that, so I'll mention it, but I won't cover it. Conversely, has your phone ever got sluggish? How about the touchscreen sometimes ignores your touch for a few seconds? That's because the processor is momentarily busy. These are the reasons I wanted the gaming specs of this phone. I should note that there are ways to speed up slow phones. This video is not about that. This phone should be less susceptible to that. There are other things to like about this phone. I hope the marketing literature I'm displaying covers it. Let's open this thing up and take a look at it, shall we? This phone is packed in a unique box presentation. I assume that they are trying to convey that the phone is different and special. It's DCS-X headphone capable and has high-res audio. This is a cooling fan you can attach to the back of the phone when you're gaming. It comes with an included minimalist case for edge and back protection without actually covering up the cooling vent and RGB ASUS gaming logo. Nice. Thick braided USB-C cable. Special 30-watt charger. The phone supports Quick Charge 4.0. These are just extra rubber covers in case you need them. Now for the phone. Look at that. Is that beautiful? I think so. All right, I'm going to activate the phone, move my SIM, and test it out. The results are next. So here it is. You see on the back, it's got the RGB light turned on. The way I have it set up, it's on when I'm using it and off when I'm not. Just as you saw in this demonstration, the RGB light has many options, very pleasing. Okay, for some more important stuff. First, the call quality is excellent. Actually, much better than my previous phone, the Galaxy Note 8. Now, I'm going to say right now that I'll be comparing this new ASUS phone to my old one. My Galaxy Note 8 is a very good phone. I was always happy with it, but this new phone is a generational improvement. As I said, call quality. It's just better on my new phone. The U.S. and international versions of the unlocked ASUS phone were both available. I bought the U.S. version specifically to have the U.S. bands configuration. It's puzzling that in my area, my Galaxy Note 8 could not make clear calls when I first purchased it. I was going to return it to Consumer Cellular, but they configured it to allow for Wi-Fi calling. Then it was okay. Its call quality outside of Wi-Fi calling was always its worst feature. So next, customization. I'm in the process of setting up my apps. I specifically did not want to backup restore all of my apps to my new phone. After 2 years of use, my Note 8 had hundreds of apps on it. And since I bought it from a carrier, it had a bunch of bloatware apps loaded as well. The new unlocked phone has no bloatware apps, so I added a dozen of my most needed apps, and now it has only 51. I'll gradually add the rest of them as needed. I did, however, backup restore all of my contacts, calendar, and other stuff. The operating system is Android 9, same as my Note 8. There is a nearby park that I go to for exercise. I almost always take my Note 8 with my Bose SoundSport wireless headphones with me. Each session takes over an hour and a half. When I listen to the Bose for the first time paired with my new ASUS phone, I was amazed at the new sound coming out of the Bose. ASUS is definitely not kidding when they say the phone has the latest NXP 9874 smart amplifiers. I also had a similar reaction when I first heard the front-firing stereo speakers. Next, the battery is really strong. I've turned up most of the knobs I can related to maxed phone enjoyment that affects battery life. Let's see. I set the display to 120 Hz. I set it to stay on for 10 minutes of unattended use before the OS would put it to sleep. 10 minutes is the max. 1 minute is the default. I set the lock screen to stay always on. I have a couple of apps that have to run continuously in the background. I did, however, set the brightness to adaptive instead of max. I've read other reviews that said this phone is too bright at night, so adaptive is appropriate. Now, about the display not having as many pixels as other major new phones, I can tell you that the pixels are so close together on these high-end phones that it just doesn't matter. For example, this phone has a resolution of 1080 by 2340 pixels. That's 391 ppi density. My Note 8 has a resolution of 1440 by 2960 pixels. That's 521 ppi density. The Note 8 display is very good. This new ASUS is just better. Why? The 120 Hz versus 60 Hz. When I looked at a 4K video from my YouTube channel on my new phone, I had a similar reaction as I did with the sound. I'd like to give you a demo here, but it wouldn't be scientific. I would be showing you how my ASUS display looks while recording on my Note 8 and vice versa. Let me just say, you wouldn't be upset with either phone. Well, with all I've said, I want to wrap up with this. Before you buy your next phone, I recommend you review the new ASUS ROG gaming phone. That's all. I think it's an overlooked phone that has a lot of great features at a modest price. You can see in my average size hand, it's probably not too big for most people. Then you can decide. For most of us, a cell phone purchase is a two-year commitment. Whatever you pick, you'll know you've picked the right phone for you. Please like and subscribe, and I hope you'll watch my video coming out in a few days on my wife's new phone, iPhone 11 Pro Max.